listening to another original mix. DJ Hemmy Boy.
I'll always think of you inside of my private thoughts. I can't imagine you touching my private parts. And just the thought of you, I can't help but touch myself. That's why I want you so bad. And just one night, yeah, what you do beside me? Oh, and I do it.
Here I am going to show you guys how to do the easiest little DIY throw poncho, whatever it's called. I don't even know what it's called, who cares, but let's go to Joann Fabric and get the fabric so we can make this.
Do it again.
Two.
Yep, that's perfect. Okay guys, so I'm getting 2 yards of this black and white striped fabric that I absolutely love. Perfect. Here's the actual ottoman in my bedroom from where I got this piece of fabric at that I turned into this poncho that we are actually going to make. So here is the gray poncho that I'm actually going to use, or that I actually used to outline the poncho that's in black and white. And this poncho, I don't know if it's called a poncho or whatever it is, but for the sake of this video, we're gonna call it a poncho, okay? So it has 3 holes in it. One here for the arm, one here for the neck, and another one here for the arm. So what I did was I just took that piece of fabric that was on my ottoman, laid it down on top of that one with 2 yards of fabric. Now you can use any fabric that you want. And I just cut out, I'm not gonna cut it because I need my fabric for my ottoman. But here's hole number one. There's hole number two right there. And there is the other armhole in there. And the only thing that you want to make sure when you do the neck is that you just want to make sure that you make this one a little lower than the back so you can distinguish the front from the back, just like it is in the gray poncho. And that is it, guys. That is all. 2 yards of fabric and folded in half. It's folded in half, and I just folded it over and cut the 3 holes. It's the same exact way that this one is done. Now, I am a rough around the edges type of girl, literally in every aspect of the word. So I did this with no sewing. I like rough edges. I am a rough edge kind of girl when it comes to my clothes. Like, I like ripped t-shirts and stuff like that. So you can see that the bottom is frayed, and I like that, but you may not. So you may want to sew yours after you cut it. But that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this DIY.